Okay. Hello and welcome to another Electronic Circuit Analysis and Design online lecture series. Today's topic is Class B and Class AB Power Amplifier Simulation. So we will first start with Class B Power Amplifier and then we'll simulate the circuit for Class AB Power Amplifier. And the main motive is to evaluate the efficiency of the simulated circuit. So let us directly start. So before going to the circuit, let us check how does the complementary push-pull Class B power amplifier looks like. So it consists of a NPN transistor, power transistor. It consists of a PNP power transistor. Both their base inputs are tied together to the input and the output is taken from the both their emitter terminals. Okay, so this is your classic complementary push-pull Class B power amplifier whose theoretical efficiency is about 78.5%. So this is the theoretical efficiency. So what we will do is we will directly build up the circuitry in LTSpice. So let us start. Okay, let us open the LTSpice simulation and click on the new schematic. So here we are. Now we have to select NPN and PNP transistors. So first we will select NPN and place it over here. The second transistor has to be a PNP. So you have to select it from here and type here PNP. Remember that the PNP orientation has to be little bit changed. So you can change from here. The emitter terminal of both the transistors should be on the same side. So here it is suitable to place now. Okay, now I have to connect. There is an option to connect a dual power supply or a single power supply. In our case, we will be connecting a dual power supply. So I'll tell you the reason a little while now, from now. So here it is, both the input base terminals is tied together and connected to the input terminal. Now let me just collect the power supply, so that is the voltage. And this is to power up the power amplifier. I'm connecting now connecting them with a wire and connecting a common ground from here. I'll now wire that ground. So we are connecting a plus or minus supply. So this I'll label it as VCC. And the lower one I'll label it as V. Let me just make this uppercase. Yeah, now it is proper. Now I can give the power supply as around plus or minus 20. Okay, the reason why we are connecting the two power supplies is, now let me just connect it over here also. Let me mark the label as VEE and on the lower side I'll mark it as V. Upper side I marked it as VCC. That is plus 20, and the lower side I'll mark it as VE, that is minus 20. So the reason why we are selecting a dual power supply is that so that the output swing is double almost. So we'll see that when we get the results. Now let us connect the input. So again we go to the component and select sine. So you get a sinusoidal input over here directly. And we can join them with a wire. And we can also connect the ground from here. Okay, so let my input amplitude, that is the sine wave amplitude, be around 18 volts. And the frequency be around 1 kilohertz. So the circuit is almost complete except for the output. and output of a power amplifier is normally driven by a very, very low impedance network. Mostly, let us consider if we are building up a power amplifier, the output load might be a speaker. So speaker is represented in the form of a resistance over here. So I can connect a resistor over here and connect it to ground like this, the other terminal. So now let us decide the value of this resistor. Normally the speaker resistor is in few ohms. So this value I label it as RL, and this I can take it around 8 ohms. So here I have given around 8 ohms. So now only thing left is to, let me just label this as Vin and Vout. So this is the Vin, and this side we have Vout. So we have labeled the input and output. We have to, since this is a power amplifier, so we have to select a power transistor. We have to select the power NPN transistor, and we have to select the power PNP transistor. So we'll go to the right click over here, pick a new transistor. So from here, we'll search a transistor have a IC having a very high value, and VC is also very high. So that's the indication of a power transistor. So we'll move a little down. Okay, so we are searching now. So let's consider the maximum case. So here we are. Here we have IC as 5000 milliamperes, that is around 5 amperes, and VCEO as 30. So we'll select this transistor for this power transistor for your NPN. And similarly, we'll select for PNP. PNP also similar IC around 5000 will do. So we are searching now. Yeah, so we got the counterpart for PNP transistor. So here also we have for this transistor, the collector current is around 5 amperes and VCO is around 30. And for upper NPN transistor, it is around 5 and 30. So both are symmetric. So these both are power transistors. Q1 and Q2 is power transistors. So let me just write it somewhere. Q1 and Q2 are power transistors with IC as 5 amperes and VCEO as around 30 volts. So that's the rating of the power transistor which we have taken. So Q1 and Q2 will be your power transistors with this much rating. Okay, let me just paste it over here. Okay, fine. Let me just cross verify the ratings. Yeah, it is 30 and 5. So the collector current is around 5 amperes for this. And the collector to emitter open circuit voltage is around 30 volts. So these are the ratings, hence it is a power transistor. Now what we need to do is we need to simulate it. So first of all, let us save this file. So let me just call this file as class B power amplifier 1. Okay, so I have to name it as a dot is dot ASC file. Now it is saved. Okay, so now we are ready to simulate the circuitry. For simulation, we should go to simulate, click on run. So it will ask us the time. So you can, the frequency is around 1 kilohertz. So you can give it around 6 milliseconds and click on OK. So we have built up the power transistor. Now let us look. Yeah, so it is the similar kind of a power transistor which we have implemented over here. You can cross check. Yeah, so it is, only thing is here, instead of the ground over here, we have connected a negative power supply just to enhance the output voltage swing. Or else everything else is same. Now let us check the output. So I'll divide this screen into two parts. So I will add plain plot And first plot I will plot as add trace V out. And second I will plot it as IRL. That is the current flowing through the load. So this is the plot. I current flowing through the load RL. So here we have plotted the output and the current flowing through the load RL. So this is my two input and the output waveform and the current through the load. So in class B power amplifier, we have a problem called as something called as crossover distortion. So while this waveform crosses zero, there is a sudden, there is a slight dead band over here. So for that period, the waveform remains almost flat. So this is what is called as crossover distortion. Let us check whether we are getting that thing in the waveforms. So what we will do is we'll expand it over here. Yeah, oh, did you see over here? So I'll expand it a little further. So you saw over here at around 0 volts and you're around 0 amperes. And we are getting a dead zone over here. So that's what is there. So you see this small crossover distortions which are visible over here. Yeah. So the crossover distortions are very much present. And that creates some problem. So we need to eliminate them. A little later, what is the elimination solution for it? So indeed, this is working as a class B power amplifier. The input amplitude is around 18 volts peak. So here we are getting close to that. Output is around, let us check the output amplitude. So I right click over here. Sorry, I'll right click on this and bring the cursor to the maximum peak. Okay, so it is around 17.16. And here also I will bring the other cursor over here. So this is around 2.1445. And this is around 17.17. So this is my peak amplitude of the output waveform and the peak amplitude of the output current waveform and the output voltage waveform. Now we have to calculate the efficiency of this class. Let me just write its name now. This is called as class B push-pull power amplifier. So that's what his name is. So we'll put it onto the screen over here. Yeah, better now. Now we have to calculate the what we call the efficiency of this class B push-pull power amplifier. So for that we need to calculate the Pin, that is the input power and the output power. So let us do that. So first we'll type here input power. That is the input DC power. So we'll write here DC is given by VCC into ICQ. So which is again equal to VCC is actually plus or minus 20. So we have to add them together. So this is around 20 minus or minus 20. So that will be around 40 volts. And ICQ can be written as into the maximum value of output current divided by pi. So that's what the value is, Im divided by pi. And now we substitute that value. Now the Im value, the maximum peak value of the current is around 2.14. So this we have already evaluated. So this I'll write it as 40 multiplied by 2.146 divided by pi. So if you work it out in your calculator, this value will come out to be around 27.32 watts. So that's the value which we are getting over here for Pin of input power. So it's not a surprise that the voltage rating, the wattage rating of the overall circuit is very high, around 27.32 watts. it's okay, this is a power amplifier, so it should be able to handle this much of power, this much of current. So here we are getting around 2.14 amperes. That's well within 5 amperes. So does the peak value, so the peak to peak value will be around somewhere around 4 point something. So it's well within the limit and it's acceptable. Now let us calculate the output power, which is given as P out of AC, that is output AC power, is given as VO RMS into IO RMS, and which can be written as, so VO RMS is VM by root 2 and IO RMS is IM by root 2. So which can be written as VOM, that is the peak value of the output and the peak value of the input divided by 2, because root 2 into root 2 will become 2. So we can multiply it by 0.5. So here, what are we getting over here? VO peak is VOM. Value is around here. What are we getting? 17.17 around. So here we are getting as 17.17 multiplied by 2.146 amperes, and this multiplied by 0.5. So this, if you work it out, you will get an answer which is close to, you can solve it in a calculator, you will get an answer which is around 18.42 watts. So that's the value of output power, which I'll place it over here. Yeah, and now we are ready to calculate the efficiency. So I can close this now. So efficiency is given by, let me just write over here, percentage efficiency of any power amplifier is given by 100 multiplied by P out of, let me just change the bracket. Yeah. So P out of AC, that is output AC power, divided by input DC power. So that's the formula. So here we can substitute these values over here. So that will be equal to 100 into P out is around 18.42 watts divided by 27.32 watts. So if you work out this number, you will get an efficiency which is close to around 67.42 percentage. So that's the efficiency of class B push-pull power amplifier. I can paste it somewhere around here. Yeah. So now that's visible. Yeah. So this is the efficiency of, let me just push this down a little. Yeah. So this is the efficiency of class B push-pull power amplifier, and that's how we calculate the input power and the output power and the efficiency for a class B push-pull power amplifier. And also we have seen the evidence of the crossover distortion. So in order to eliminate this crossover distortion, we go for class AB power amplifier. So let me just close this now. So we'll go for class AB push-pull power amplifier. So let us go back to our theoretical page over here. So here we have it as, this is the crossover distortion which we have already observed in this class B power amplifier. Next we'll see its remedy. So its remedies that, I'll just open up the slide. Okay, so this complementary push-pull class B power amplifier, which we have simulated over here, has gave us the efficiency of 67.42 percentage. That is the rate of conversion from, that is the AC power which is getting converted from the DC power over here at the output. It is converted around 67.42 percentage. So 67.42 percentage of DC power is getting converted into AC. Rest is a waste of power. So the efficiency is around 67, and the theoretical efficiency of the same is around 75.78.5. And now let us see the method to overcome this. So the method to overcome this is class AB power push-pull power amplifier with diode biasing. So this is the circuitry. So again, we have this NPN power transistor. You have a PNP power transistor. Here we have connected the positive and the negative power supply. We have additionally two biasing resistors over here. This is R1 and R2. And we have two diodes connected from here to here. So let us keep this open for some time. And then we can, continue to build up the circuitry side by side. So let me just minimize this a little and continue to work on the screen. So we have to remember, we have to build this circuitry in LTSpice also. So what I will do is, as most of the circuitry for class AB is almost the same, we will copy paste this into the new screen and then we'll work out from there. So what I mean is, you zoom out a little and you just use this copy button, drag it and open a new schematic and paste it on here. So it's as simple as that. And if you just zoom full extent, you will get back this. So this is a new schematic and this was an older one. So this will be a class, we have to modify it as per the, this circuit to your right over here. So let us start. So first of all, what we will do is, we will give some space over here. So we'll remove this. Okay, and we add the diodes. One diode will be over here and another diode will be over here. Right? So as per the diagram onto your right hand side of your screen, we are doing it. And here it is completed. Now we have to add two resistors, one over here and one over here. So this is class AB push-pull power amplifier with diode biasing. So we are not discussing the mechanics of the details of the working of the circuitry. We are just trying to find the simulate the circuitry in LTSpice and find its theoretic find its efficiency of the circuitry. So that's how the circuit looks like, and almost the circuit is complete. Now let us give this value of R1 as around 100 ohms. And this R2 value also will give it as around 100. Rest all the parameters will keep the same. We have kept the transistor also same, that is both the power transistors, NPN and PNP. And output load resistance is also around 8, let it be 8 only. And the diodes, we can right click on it and select the diode as a practical diode, that is IN414. So you can select this. And obviously you can select this also. That is IN414. Okay, so just by these few modifications, our circuit is ready. This is class AB push-pull power amplifier, which will definitely eliminate the crossover distortion observed in class B power amplifier. So before going there, let us save this file first. So let me just save it as power amplifier, class AB power amplifier. Now the file is saved. Now only thing we have to do is, we might have to change the some values over here, that is the peak values of the current and the voltages, we might have to change slightly. So apart from that, everything is ready now. So we are ready to simulate the circuitry. I can close this now and I can maximize this window. Just wait a sec. Yeah. So now it is maximized and now we are ready to start with the simulation. Let me just close this also. I'll save the changes. Yeah. So let me just simulate it. I'll click on run. So again, the time period is around 0 to 6 milliseconds. I'll right click over here, add plane plot. So for the first plane plot, I will add as Vout. So this is my Vout. And for the second plane plot, I will plot IRL. That is the current flowing through RL. That is the output current over here. So this is my output voltage and the current waveforms. As you can see, the waveforms are without any crossover distortion. So we'll expand this section and check. As you can see, there is no dead zone region over here when the waveform is crossing zero. So it is completely eliminated. The crossover distortion earlier observed in class B power amplifier is completely eliminated. And theoretically, the efficiency of class A, B and B is almost the same. Now let us check the efficiency of this circuit over here. So I'll go here over here and first check the peak waveforms of the peak amplitude of close this once again. Yeah, so I'll check the peak amplitude of the output waveform. This is around 17.64 and the peak amplitude of the peak amplitude of output waveform and the peak current of the output waveform current. Now let us add these values over here. So the formulas and all, everything will remain exactly the same. Only thing is that slightly these variations will be there. So here the formula will be same. The IO, the peak value of current will be instead of 2.2, instead of 2.146, it will be 2.206. And if you work out this number, 40 multiplied by 2.2 divided by pi, you will get a number which is around 28.11. So that's the modification which we are looking at. And here also your peak value of output voltage will change slightly. It is right now it is 17.65. So 17.65 and this is around 2.206. So if you multiply 17.6 by multiplied by 2.206 multiplied by 0.5, you will get this number as around 19.5. So you can check these numbers with the calculator. So the input power and the output power is evaluated. Now let us calculate the efficiency. So efficiency, again the formula will be the output power upon the input power. So the output power formula is around how much it is? 19.5 watts and the input power is around 28.11 watts. So if you work out this number in a calculator, you will get efficiencies around 69.37 efficiency percentage wise. So this is due to slight losses in this resistors also, which we have over here, and also it depends upon the value of these resistors also. So more or less it's quite similar and quite close to theoretical efficiency, which was around 78.5. so here we can write it down over here, the theoretical efficiency was around 78.5%. And we are getting around 69.37. That's absolutely fine. And because we have selected a power transistors of a very high rating, that is 5 amperes and voltage rating of 30 volts. So as you saw in this, the output waveforms does not contain any crossover distortion whatsoever, neither the output current, nor I can maximize the output current also. So here you can see there is absolutely no distortion at all. As you can see, the ratings of the current is around in amperes. That has to happen because it is a power amplifier and the output voltage is also pretty high. So one reason why it is called as a power amplifier, because the input amplitude itself is very, very high. This is around 18 volts peak and the output is also nearby around 17, close to 18 volts, so which is around 17.65. So the input is pretty high, so it is also called as a large signal amplifier. And this is a class AB push-pull power amplifier, giving you a little better efficiency compared to class B power amplifier, push-pull power amplifier. So that's it for this lecture. So we have completed class B. So we have completed the class B power amplifier and class AB power amplifier and evaluated its efficiency. So in the next lecture, online lecture series, we'll start with another topic. So until then, have a good day and thank you.